morning and Sairam students. Hope you all are fit and fine at your home. So with that, let us start with our today's class. So as you all know that in our last class, we have started a new chapter named The Bond of Love by Kenneth Anderson from Behive. So students, we have learned in the last class that the narrator, Kenneth, has gifted a baby bear to his wife. And that baby bear was given a lot of love and affection in that home. He was named as Bruno because he was a male. He was a male bear, and that's why he was given a name, Bruno. Author's or narrator's wife was really affectionated, or you can say was having a very close relation with the bear. And even Bruno has also adapted that this is my own house, and he eats everything, whatever is cooked in the house, he drinks everything. So he was now comfortable at that place. He considered it as his home. He is more likely now a friend to the dogs also. So everyone was considering Bruno as a family member. He was not given a place of a pet, but as a family member. And even the wife of the narrator considered Bruno as his own son. And that's why later on, she named him Baba. Now, two incidents happen when the thought came into the mind of the family member that now Bruno should be shifted to the zoo because it is not a perfect place for him to live here, because now he is growing up. And when he is growing up, he is becoming more fearful to everyone. The children who are living there, the peoples, the strangers who are coming to meet the family. So they all are afraid of Bruno. Plus, he had barium carbonate, which was a poison kept for the rats. Even he got paralyzed due to that. But for God's sake, he was saved by the doctor. And the second time, he drank the engine oil. So after seeing such incident taking place, and he is now becoming more big and big, which is not good for them to keep him at their place. So now they consider that we should send him to the zoo. And they have talked to the curator of the zoo also. Curator means in charge, to keep Bruno there. And he agreed with this. And later on, they all tried to convince the mother of the wife of the narrator that we should now keep him in the zoo because it is not safe for us to keep him here. So even she also agreed. After when all such thing took place, when he was shifted to the zoo, what happened that for few weeks the narrator wife didn't eat anything because she was not happy from inside. She was feeling very lonely after Bruno left. So now when she talked to the in charge of the zoo, He also confirmed the news that yes, Bruno is also not eating anything and he is very quiet. So this was what all we have read in the last class. Now today we are going to move on. So let us start with that. She would ask her friend visiting Mysore to visit Baba and check out on him. Everyone gave a similar report that Baba was fine, but appeared thin and sad. The staff at the zoo said that he seemed worried. The narrator restrained his wife from visiting the zoo for 3 months. One day, she said that she wanted to see Baba, and if he would not take her, then she would go herself by train or bus. Finally, they went to see Baba at the zoo. So what happened when once the family friend visited Mysore, the narrator wife requested them to please visit the zoo also and see if Baba is fine or not. Now, when they came back, they gave the news that he was fine, but he appeared very thin and sad. He was not happy. He was not cheerful. And now even the staff member also says this thing that he was very worried. He never seems happy. He sit quietly in one corner. Now here the narrator is trying to stop his wife from going to the zoo because he knew that if she will go there, then it will be very difficult for them to separate them. So now for 3 months the narrator didn't let his wife to go to the zoo. But after that, one day what happened? One day she said, now I want to go. It is your wish you want to accompany with me or not, but I will go by myself, either by train or by bus. Finally, the narrator agreed and he also visited to the zoo to see Baba. Their friend had predicted that Baba would not recognize her, and the narrator had thought so too. But to his amazement, she was a few steps away from the cage when Baba saw her and recognized her. He screamed with happiness. She ran up to him, petted him, and Baba was very happy to have her back. So what happened? Now, the friends who have visited the zoo previously, they predict that he will not see you, or he will, after seeing you, he will not recognize you, to the narrator wife. He said that. And even the narrator is also saying this thing, that he will not recognize you, why you are going there, because he has now adapted that area as his home. He has forgotten you. But what happened? Everything happened oppositely. What? When the wife visited that zoo, from a very few place, Baba recognized her and he screamed with happiness. And when the narrator wife ran up to him, patted him, patted means when you do like this, patted. This is called patted. When he patted, when she patted him, Baba was very happy and he was very happy with the narrator's wife. She remained there for 3 hours. She fed Baba different things which were his favorite. As the zoo had to close, they have to leave. The narrator's wife did not want to leave Baba and both of them cried bitterly. Even the zoo in charge was sad. The narrator was fine because he knew that the next step would be to take Baba back along to Bengaluru. So now what happened when for 3 hours she sat there and she fed her the favorite food of Baba? But when the time came to close the zoo, the narrator wife have to go. But she was not ready to go because she don't want to leave Baba right now. And they both were crying bitterly. Even the in charge was very sad to see such thing. But what happened? The narrator has made up his mind that now I will take Baba back to our place to Bengaluru. The wife requested the in charge that she wanted to take Baba back. He replied that the bear was government property and that she needed permission from the superintendent in Bengaluru. So now, as they have taken him in a very small age to their place and they have not taken any government permission because wild animals are the government property. So now, if they want to take Baba back to their place, they have to take the government permission. So for this, they have to visit superintendent in Bengaluru for the permission. Now what happened next? Let us see. They returned to Bengaluru and visited the superintendent at his bungalow. She cried and requested that both of them had been worrying for each other. She requested to have Baba back. The superintendent was a kind-hearted man and he accepted her request. He wrote to the zoo in charge to arrange a cage for transporting Baba to Bengaluru. So now here we got to know that superintendent was a very kind-hearted person and he even accepted the request of the wife and he wrote a letter to zoo in charge that now you should arrange for a cage so that you can transfer Baba from Mysore to Bengaluru. They went to Mysore with the superintendent's letter. Baba was put in a cage and the cage was kept on the top of the car. It was tied securely and they returned to Bengaluru. At their home in Bengaluru, a team of workers was employed to execute some work in the backyard. As Baba was a full-grown bear, he had to be kept isolated. So, an island which was 20 feet long and 15 feet wide was built. It was surrounded by a dry pit which was 6 feet wide and even 7 feet deep. It was made like this because the bear would not be able to cross the pit over to areas that were inhabited by people, as it could be a threat to them. Things which were used by Baba had been kept securely. So now what happened when they have shifted from Mysore to Bengaluru? Certain work have to be done in their home, that is to create an island, isolated land, that is known as island. And there they have made a house or a home for Baba, where they have made a very long isolated island which was 20 feet long and 15 feet wide. Why? Because to ensure that Baba should not cross that place and it will be safe for the inhabitants who are living nearby. Things which were used by Baba even also are kept there. These were kept on the islands. They were a wooden box which was previously used to keep cocks and hens and would now be used by Baba to sleep in at night. A wooden box was kept there so that Baba could sleep on that. Straw was kept in the box to keep him warm. Straw means the you can say the dry sticks. These are known as straw. The piece of wood which Baba cradled like a baby, the stick that he used to point a gun, were also placed on the island so that he could play with them. When the place was ready, the worker placed the cage on the island and Baba was removed from it. He was happy to be free, stood on his back legs, pointed the stick and cradled the piece of wood. The narrator's wife spent many hours with him as he lay in her lap, although he was 15 months old and he was quite heavy in weight. The narrator's wife visits Baba frequently and the way in which she reaches and leaves the island is interesting. They have a rope tied to a mango tree with a loop at one end. She would place one foot in the loop and kick off with the other. This way she could fly in the air to cover the six foot long distance to reach the island. She would make the return trip in a similar way. On seeing the affection shared by Baba and the narrator's wife, we can conclude that animals have emotion. They remember people and all of them have individual qualities just like human beings have. So now, as we know that Baba was living on an island and between that island and their home, a big tunnel was made of such a 15 feet and 20 feet tunnel was made just to ensure that he should not cross that area and should not come out in the society. So it was very difficult for narrator's wife to visit Baba. So they have made what? They have tied a rope and on that rope they have tied a loop on which she would kick and she would went to the other place and she could come in the same way. So she is using rope way to visit Baba. And this was all about your The Bond of Love by Kenneth Anderson, which shows the love between an animal and a human. With this, we complete this chapter. That's all for today. Thank you, students. Take care.